school. I hate him too, just for that. Hello. You guys are really close. I'm into a lot of weird LA like health trends. I tried out this thing recently where I didn't have sex or masturbate for 30 days, which I think allowed me to watch porn objectively. Because I was watching a porn and we're probably, I don't know, 3/4 of the way through, it's still going through character development. I was confused. I'm like, I'm sorry, what, is this Game of Thrones? It was actually. It was Game of Thrones. I went to the dentist recently, and I hadn't been to the dentist in a long time. It's been about 10 years. Yeah, I know. I also have 63,000 unread emails. That's just who I am. Women love to hear these stats. Like, oh my god, you have debt too? Yeah, I got a lot of debt. So the hygienist eventually comes in, and going into the appointment, I was you know, expecting the worst. Cavities, root canal, I don't know, diabetes. I don't think they tried for that. And the hygienist, you know, she comes in, she starts doing the x-rays, and she does this thing where she'll do the x-ray and then she'll look at it right after. And she does this for like 10 minutes, and I'm expecting an update. I want to know if I'm going to die. She's like, this is a dentist's office, we don't really check for that. And she doesn't say anything for 10 minutes, and the first thing she says, she doesn't say it to me, she says it to her coworker. She calls her over, she's looking at the x-rays, she says, Mina. I don't know if anybody here knows Spanish. Mina means this guy's got fucked up teeth. The doctor eventually comes in, and I have nothing wrong with me. I have no idea why. Somebody said it was because of white privilege. Could be the case. So I'm a cat owner. Not sure if that's obvious. Cat fans, I guess. A little bit about my cat. He's a rescue. From Craigslist. I rescued him from Craigslist. That's a real rescue. I'm sure if you've been on that website. He's half black and half white. His fur, not his identity, relax. And he's a, what do they call it, an asshole. He doesn't like to cuddle with me, but he will every once in a while. And I try to cherish those moments. He'll come and, you know, lay on me. He'll decide where he wants to lay. And cats do this thing called kneading, where they kind of like extend their claws into your body. This is how they show affection. Cats show affection, in case you weren't aware. And whenever he does this, he likes to do it like right into my penis. Which is awkward, but I'm also trying to like repair the relationship. So I kind of just let him do it. I later found out that cats, actually, another reason why they do kneading is it's an instinctual thing. It reminds them of their mother's teeth, and they press into it, you know, for milk production. And I've been letting them do this on my penis. So people might not think we have the best relationship. But, you know, I think he loves me enough to, you know, at least try to jerk me off. So I'm newly single, clearly from that cat rant. Newly single, that's just the sad way to just say it. I'm single. It didn't really end well. He's like, fuck you and your relationship. That didn't end well. It ended on good terms. Because when it ends on good terms, you don't have that like post-breakup like anger and rage that you use to like motivate you and do things. You know, like you'll join a yoga class or travel to Europe, murder your ex, you know, that kind of stuff. when I became single, you know, you realize all the stuff that you don't get to do anymore because you only did it with that person. Like, I had a moment when I realized I don't get to watch The Bachelor anymore. I don't feel bad. I can still watch The Bachelor. It's streaming, but I'm okay. I met somebody recently who was, like, really nice. You know those types? Always throws me off. Because they're like that to everybody they meet. And that's a lot to know about somebody. My Uber driver, he was really nice. He offered, like, a phone charger and a water, and, like, he didn't even get to know me. Like, he led with nice. And then, like, he asked me if he could eat his own cookie. I was like, yeah, dude, of course. Like, as soon as this ride's over, eat the cookie. So, I'm single. I'm not dating or anything yet, but I guess I'm looking. I'm not really good at introducing myself to women, especially when there's, like, a bunch of other women around and they're doing weird poses and they're sweating. Yoga class. Because if you try to hit on a girl in yoga class and it doesn't go well, then you're that guy in yoga class. You don't get to go back. But it's always this debate, like, I'll see a cute girl in yoga class, and my logical brain, it knows what to do. It's just like, hey, focus on your pigeon pose. But then my reptile brain is like, hey, you should check out her pigeon pose. I like to find reasons to not talk to women. That sounds a lot easier. I like when this happens, when you see somebody you're really attracted to, and then you start imagining your future together, and then they kind of just do something that ruins it for you. I like that just because I like closure. Like, there was this girl in yoga class, and I thought she was cute, but then in the middle of Shavasana, quiet time, she was just talking to her friend for, like, the duration of Shavasana, to a point where I said, hey, you're fucking up my Shavasana. And we're not getting married. I'll end on this. I've been living with my roommate for about 6 months, and we haven't farted in front of each other yet. But the other day, he used fart in a sentence. So I know he's thinking about it. I think he wants a fart first base. Anyway, that's my time. My name is Nick Reed. Thank you so much.
Letting us all know what it looked like if Charlie Day used one of those face swap apps with an infant. Alright. Not all of them are great, but fuck you, you've laughed at most, alright? We've got one more comic and then you're absolutely awesome, fucking fantastic headliner. So stick around. This next comedian, you can catch her here. Obviously, you can catch her at the Federal Bar in North Hollywood. She also performs with Cherry Poppins. Give it up for Robot Kelly!